Black rectangular hole in the ground. Light everlasting, would that the light of inspiration had not left me.
Destroyed it out. He's gone, as suddenly as he came, a traveller from beyond the Alps. Should I go to beyond the mountains? Should I let him pass be my guide? Should I give up the fruitless travel with a wife? I have always kept a close watch over my development as a writer, over my behavior as a man. Should I now, without thought, break my habit, my summer of work in the mountains, to holiday in the warm and lovely south? The break can be justified, of course, by this growing fatigue, which no one must suspect. And that I must not betray by any sense of flagging inspiration. Yes, it can be justified. But the truth is that it has been precipitated by a sudden desire for the unknown. So be it. I will pursue this freedom and offer up my days to the sun and the south. My ordered soul shall be refreshed at last.
Girls alone, there are plenty where we're going.
Let
Casanova, me make trouble. I don't know what trouble is, do I?
Oh, I don't know what trouble is,
I don't know what trouble is.
My beauty,
my beauty, my beauty.
Au revoir.
but darling, don't you know?
Passion confuses the senses, ambiguous Venice, ambiguous Venice.
Passengers must follow,
ambiguous Venice.
Follow where I lead, no choice for the living, no choice for the dead.
There is the man going, I want to go to Scavone.
The Signora is going to the lead.
Yes, by Vaporetto.
The Signore cannot go by Vaporetto. The Vaporetto does not take baggage.
That is my affair. You will turn round.
Nobody shall bid me. I go where I choose. I go my own way, I have nothing to lose.
Is it money he's after?
The Signore will pay.
I will pay nothing if you do not take me where I want to go.
To the leader. now.
But not with you.
I know you well.
Here as well. I shall leave him alone.
They know how I love
them. To my
dream. They take what's a gift.
The spell of the Lord and in the left happy.
Not while I live.
Especially. Venice once again, egregio signor von Aschenbach. The writer who has found a way to reconcile art and honors, the lofty purity of whose style has been officially recognized, and who has accepted, even welcomed, the austere demands of maturity. Yes, I turned away from the paradox and daring of my youth. Renounce bohemianism and sympathy with the outcast to concentrate upon simplicity, beauty, form. Upon these all my art is built. Now in this beautiful, agreeable place, I intend to give myself to the leisured world for a spell. Pleasant journey, did he say? The whole experience was odd, unreal, out of normal focus. Was I wrong to come? What is there in store for me here? But there is the sea, and nearby Serenissima. Though the sky is still grey, here every hint of shadow.
Ti patali, si arrizzati di piantali, a capriccio di piazzali, ti patali. yes, 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 yes,
yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes,
yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes,
yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes,
the soul of Greece lies in that bright perfection, a golden look, a timeless air. Mortal child, with more than mortal grace.
Such beauty come about? What mysterious harmony between the individual and the universal law produces such perfection of form? Would the child be less good, less valuable as a human being if he were less beautiful? The fact is that in that disciplined family, beauty dominates. The severe, plain little girls must be quiet, demure. The elegant boy may show off his grace. No doubt Mama, with her fabulous pearls, indulges herself in a pampering, partial love, just as I indulge myself in these novelist speculations. There is indeed in every artist's nature a wanton and treacherous prose to side with beauty.
Thank you.
completa sì, immeasurable, unorganized, void. I long to find rest in perfection, and is not this a form of perfection? Ah, here comes Eros, his very self. I was not mistaken, it is very good. So, a little Polish god is proud, proud like all his race. He is human after all. There is a dark side, even perfection. I like that.
Is it on Thaddeus, sure for Thaddeus, and you?
Thank you. my little beauty, you notice when you're noticed, you notice when you're noticed. Strives to create beauty, to liberate from the marble mass of language the slender forms of an art. I might have created him. Perhaps that is why I feel a father's pleasure, a father's warmth in the contemplation of. Yes, Aschenbach, you have grown reserved, self-sufficient since the death of a wife and marriage of an only daughter. Dependent not upon human relationships, but upon work, and again work. How much better to live not words, but beauty, to exist in it and on it. How much better than my detached and solitary way. But where? Rosias. I must go elsewhere. I must find a clearer sky, a fresher air. Understand how regretful, unfortunate, we shall be sorry to lose you. But of course, if the Signore has reasons, then he must go. No doubt the Signore will return to us in his own good time. Meanwhile, our deepest respects, and please keep us in mind. Arrivederci, Signore.
Giulio, vieni qui. The Signore's baggage, presto, presto.
Sì, pronto. Sì, sì. It is here. The motorboat is waiting.
It is too soon. You allow too much time. I will not be hurried. I will follow by gondola.
Bene, signore.
Yes, I must go. Does it seem fresher this morning? Can the wind have changed?
Signore.
You must find it. Get it back. Without it, I cannot go. You understand? I cannot go. I shall return to the hotel. Arrange for the baggage to be sent back there.
Very good, signore. In the twinkling of an eye, it shall be back. Gondoliere, to the Lido at once.
Of my early heroes, passive in the face of fate. What do I really want? First, I am grief-stricken, but must go because of the danger to my health. And then I am furious because I am forced to return. I rejoice, vacillating, irresolute, absurd.
whole experience has been disruptive to my thoughts and to my work. Yet, in spite of it, I feel my spirits rise. What is often called disruptive is not directed against life, but is invigorating a renewal. The charming Tadjo. That's what it was. That's what made it hard to leave. So be it. So be it. Stay here, dedicate my days to the sun and Apollo himself. Thank you.
what the world waits for, rejoicing in his presence. When thought becomes feeling, feeling thought, when the mind bows low before beauty, when nature perceives the aesthetic moment, contemplation for one moment of reality. Admiration of all. I must say, well done. I must speak to him, speak to him. We will become friends. It is easy, nothing more natural. Too late. I couldn't, couldn't. This is frenzy, absurd. The heat of the sun must have made me ill. So long he passes back and forth between the life and the mind. Should be smiled at like that.
it has come to this. I can find no better description of my state than the hackneyed words. I love you. Overcome by beauty, I tried quite simply to use the emotion released for my own creation. What I wrote was good, quite what was expected of me, to the point yet poignant. But when it was done, I felt degraded, as if I had taken part in an orgy. Then I was moved to put this relationship, if so one-sided an affair can be called a relationship, onto a natural footing. I would hail the boy, exchange a few words with him. I couldn't do it. My beating heart and trembling limbs refused to obey my will. So I had to mock myself as a crestfallen lover. Who really understands the workings of the creative mind? Nonetheless, oh, be it. This I love you must be accepted. Ridiculous, but sacred too, and no, not dishonorable, even in these circumstances.
Guardate, signore, va bene, signore.
Yes, the weather is idyllic. Too hot. Oh, just a trifle. The hotel gets a fewer.
Guardate, signore, va bene, signore. You'll end up if you please.
But what was that you're saying? You hear less German? Your compatriots are always very careful. That's so nice. Take the von Becks. I've tended Herr von Beck for many summers. A splendid head of hair, if I may say so. Remarkable for someone in his middle years and such a youthful scheme.
Guardate, signore. Each year they spend the summer with us. Va bene, signore.
And now, after 10 days, they have gone back to the cold and welcoming north, head up just a little. The signore is not leaving us. He does not fear the sickness, has he?
Sickness?
What sickness? Nothing. I know nothing.
What? You mentioned it.
It's not important. It is
you must know what you mean.
Take it, sir. It is not important.
You fancy the soil, sir, a delectable censer. The signore now takes little interest in such things, I know.
That is it, signore. Next week at the same time.
Va bene, signore.
Prego, prego.
Sickness? What sickness?
More than a malaise from the Scirocco. A sickness to drive people on.
hot season. Citizens must not use the canal waters for household purposes.
This sweetish smell that pervades the air, my friend.
Susie,
what are these warnings?
Just a form of precaution, sir.
Police regulation, sir, with which we must conform.
No,
I tell you, Morton, sir. Precaution, ring. Let me guide the signore.
Basta, basta,
Susie, signore. Officially denied. Rumors of an incipient plague in Venice officially denied. Ah, here it is. We doubt the good faith of the Venetian city fathers in the refusal to admit to the cases of cholera in the city. German citizens should return as soon as possible. Ah, rumors. They should be silent. The city secret growing darker every day, like the secret in my own heart. They must receive no hint. They must not be told. They must not be. Of chance encounters, painful hopes, and silent communion.
yet am I driven on. Yet am I driven on. Yet am I driven on.
Gustav von Aschenbach, what is this path you have taken? What would your forebears say, decent, stern men, in whose respectable name and under whose influence? You, the artist, made the life of art into a service,
a hero's life of struggle and abstinence. Yes, but when heroes have flourished, heroes has flourished too. It was no shame to them to be enthralled. Rather, it brought them praise, it brought them honor.
This way for the players, signori. This way. But you'll enjoy it. Yes, they come each year. It is the custom.
Take your places, signori.
Ha, 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 ha not laugh like the others? Does your innocence keep you aloof? Or do you look to me for guidance? Do you look to me?
Information, please. It is most urgent.
Please pay attention to me.
Information.
One moment, if you please.
Horse places in the wagon, leave for the
night. My dear young man, listen to me,
One moment, if you please.
All
to France,
all
to France. Urgent, I cannot wait.
I'm sorry, signori. We are closed. Precautions in this weather. Is that the truth? Sir, that is what they say, what we are told to believe. But last years, Asiatic cholera has spread from the delta of the Ganges to Hindustan, to China, Afghanistan, and thence to Persia. They thought it would travel westwards by land, but it came by sea to the southern ports, Malaga, Palermo. Last May, two dead bodies were discovered here in Venice with signs of the plague. It was hushed up. In a week, there were 10 more, 20, 30. A guest from Austria went home and died, hence the reports in the German newspapers. The authorities denied it. The city had never been healthier, they said. Sir, death is at work. The plague is
flourishes, redoubles its powers. It is violent, convulsive, suffocating. Few who contract it recover. The Ospedale Civico is full. The traffic to San Michele is continuous. And, sir, the authorities are not moved by scruples or by international agreements. They fear for their pockets if there should be panic or blockade. Meanwhile, the city is demoralized. Crime, drunkenness, murder, organized vice, evil forces are rife. Sir, take my advice. The blockade cannot be far off. Rather than put it off till tomorrow, you would do well to leave today.
Thank you, young man.
Good night, sir. It is true, every word.
So it is true, true, more fearful than I thought. I must warn them, or the lady of the pearls, speak to her now. Madam, I will say, allow a perfect stranger to give you a warning. Madam, I will say, go away at once, you are in danger. Venice is in the grip of the plague. Do you not see how everyone is leaving? You must go too with your daughters and with Tadu, your son. Madam, I will say, madam. Once again, I have failed to make everything decent and above board. Missed the opportunity to become myself again. Missed the opportunity to regain my reason, my self-possession. But what is self-possession? What is reason, moral sense? What is art itself compared to the rewards of chaos? The city's secret, desperate, disastrous, destroying, is my hope. I will not speak.
What if all were dead? And only we two left alive.
taste the sacrifice. Join the worshippers. Embrace.
Taste of knowledge, of knowledge. Let the gods do what they will with me.
Now, if you were to tone up the skin, oh, just a little.
bring back the appearance of youth. Va bene, signore. It gives some brilliance to the eyes. Nothing brightens the face like the eyes. Hit back, signore. Quite, quite still. An excellent subject, if I may say so. Guardate, signore, va bene, signore. Prego, prego, a masterpiece, a masterpiece. Now the signore can fall in love with a good grace. Prego, 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 prego. Addio, signore, addio, signore.
The pretty little darling, don't you
if all were dead, and only we two left alive. Oh, Aschenbach, famous as a master, self-discipline, your strength. Oh, folly, oh, pretense! Perilous, perilous weakness!
Addio!
First one goes, now they all
gentlemen.
Be silent. Who comes and goes is my affair. Buongiorno, Signor von Aschenbach. To their home in the cold, cold north beyond the mountain. After luncheon, to be sure. Yes, Signor von Aschenbach, the season comes to an end.
Thank you.